Hello everyone, in this video we have one rectangle and these three parts are given as 4 units and the area of the blue shaded triangle is given 30 cm squared. So the question is, what is the area of the yellow shaded triangle? Okay. First step, if it is 8 units, that means here must be equal 8 units. And then this side length, let's call here x. Therefore, this side must be equal x plus 4. Right? Okay. And then let's call here a. And here, let's call B. If you focus on triangle BGC, I want to represent this triangle area with capital A. So, if we calculate the rectangle area equal 8 times x plus 4. So, 8x plus 32. Right? Okay. So now, if we calculate this triangle area, so area of the triangle BEC equal 30 plus capital A. At the same time, we know that the area of the triangle BEC is also equal half of the rectangle area, right? Why? Because let's remind you, if we have a triangle, let's draw one triangle inside it like this, and let's call here 2y, and here, let's call h. If we calculate this triangle area, the triangle area equal 2y times h over 2. So, y times h. And rectangle area equal 2y times h. Equal 2y times h. That means ratio of triangle area and ratio of the rectangle area equal 1/2. So the area of the triangle BEC equal half of the rectangle area. That means capital A equal 4x minus 14. Right? Therefore, let's write here 4x minus 14, and let's clear here. After that, if we extend this two corner like this, let's call here point K. If you focus on this butterfly, notice that ratio of these two parts equal 1. That means if here is x plus 4, so here must be equal x plus 4. Right? So now if you focus on the other butterfly, ratio of these two sides, a over b, must be equal ratio of these two sides, 2x plus 4 over x plus 4, right? Okay, this is the first equation. And then, if you focus on this triangle and this triangle have same height, right? That means ratio of their bases must be equal ratio of their areas. So 30 over 4x minus 14. Okay, this is the second equation. If you notice that right-hand side of the equation are equal, that means left-hand side of the equation must be equal. Therefore, if we equalize first and second equation, 2x plus 4 over x plus 4 must be equal 30 over 4x minus 14. If we simplify the expression, and after the cross multiplication, 15x plus 60 equal 4x squared minus 14x plus 8x minus 28. Therefore, 4x squared minus 21x minus 88 equals 0. So 4x squared equal 4x times x and minus 88 equal 11 times negative 8. That means 4x plus 11 times x minus 8 equals 0. So x equal minus 11 over 4. This cancels out. That means x equal 8 units. Therefore, here is 12 and this area is 18 centimeters squared, right? That means A over B must be equal 30 over 18, so 5 over 30, right? That means if there's a 5k here, this length must be equal 3k. After that, let's clear here. If we extend these two points, if you focus on a stringle and stringle have same height, that means if this area equal 3a, this triangle area must be equal 5a, right? So now, if you focus on triangle BFE, this triangle and this triangle have same height and same bases. That means these two triangles have same areas. We know that x equal 8. So let's clear here. The area of triangle BAE equal 8 times 8 over 2. So at the same time, this triangle area is also equal 3, 5, 8. So 16 times capital A. Therefore, 32 equal 16 times capital A. So capital A equal 2 centimeter squared. Final step. Notice that yellow shaded area equal the area of the AEFG equal 13 times capital A. So the area of the yellow shaded region equal 26 centimeter squared. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.